Good morning. It's Tuesday, 5 October. And I think I'm going to take out the Buell today. This is my 2000 Buell XB12R Firebolt. I've only got about 7,500 original miles on it. For those watching my stuff now, it seems a few more people are interested in my channel. I did a video earlier in the year on my Buell before I got this bike, talking about the Indian, and had mentioned that I bought this from a California transplant to New Mexico, from a area just a little north of Albuquerque, and she had only put actually 1800 miles on the bike, and I think the bike kind of scared her, so she never really rode it in California. So this is actually a California bike, so it has some extra emissions garbage inside. Haven't really asked my Buell mechanic if it affects anything with the power of the bike, but the bike has more than enough power for me. I'm not really a track guy. I probably will eventually get to the track because you can learn a lot of useful skills. And it's been a while since I took a rider course. When I was in the Army, I did the motorcycle safety course because that was a requirement in the United States Army. And then they had me do a refresher about 4 years later, 3 years later. So it wasn't actually a refresher. It was the next level. Which was the experienced rider course. So the Army had us do those, at least when I was in the military. And the second course is actually pretty good. The first course was excellent. I actually had to unlearn some bad habits I had developed because my Sportster, this bike right here, was my primary means of transportation when I got back from Germany to the States. So I rode that Sporty in the rain and the snow. Because my wife, our only other reliable vehicle was that black F-150, a 97 F-150. And she needed that for work, so I rode this Sporty every day, rain or snow or good weather, when I was at Fort Benning, Georgia. And so I was able to get a temporary driver's license, and before I could get into the course, which for us in the Army was offered for free. It's pretty expensive if you're not in the military, but it's well worth it. So I developed a few bad habits, even though I had read stuff way back then in 2001. And it actually made the course a little challenging for me because having to unlearn some bad habits I had picked up the few months I was riding without having gone through the course. And the course was very helpful. So taking that second course was definitely another helpful both refresher and then learning some more advanced techniques. So I guess all that to get to the point that I would like to go do some track days and get some instruction from some professional sport bike riders and develop some techniques for the track. I know that not all track techniques and skills that you learn for tracking your bike translate to the normal streets where I ride my bikes most of the time. That Indian right there is now my daily rider, and like I posted in the video with my buddy who just bought the new Sportster-S, I have nowhere near the skills required to take that FTR, or for that matter this Buell, to its limits. And this Buell will definitely outdo that Indian, even with all the rider aids, and as great as that bike is, my Firebolt will definitely do better than the Indian does in the twisties. It's got a short wheel base, and for those not familiar with the Buells and Eric Buell, he's a genius of an engineer, and he works some magic into the chassis of this bike with his with the frame and the geometry of the bike. It's got a really steep angle on the front forks, very short wheelbase, which you would think would make this bike unstable at speed, but I've ridden it up to about 120 miles an hour and it's extremely stable. I believe the top speed of this bike is 153 or 155, and I don't think I'll ever get it up that fast. You really got to tuck in. And I don't have the skills to be going that fast on the bike. I've taken this one up to 124 miles an hour, but it's governed at 124. I didn't know that at the time. But it is governed at 124 miles. There's a lot of guys that have sent the ECM, whatever it is in the bike, to some FTR guru in the Carolinas, one of the Carolinas. And he has become the stateside expert on FTRs. And he does something with the ECM or whatever part of the computer and ungoverns the bike. And I don't know what the top speed is of the bike, but it's well past 124 from what little I've seen. But I don't need to be going that fast on it. Like I said, it's my daily rider. So I'm going to take this out today. Go see if how my buddy's doing with his new Sportster over at Santa Fe Harley-Davidson. But I love this bike for sure. I don't know how many folks are familiar with Buells, but Harley-Davidson definitely made a mistake. Part of the reason they were caught flat-footed by Harley-Davidson and then a lot of the other companies that have started producing very good naked bikes and sport bikes. Sad to see that Harley-Davidson didn't produce the Bronx to come along with the new Sporty. But maybe the Bronx will come out with their 2022 announcement here in a few months. Well, there's my other Harley. My wife and I tour on this, but we're upgrading. We are so happy with Indian Motorcycle Company with this bike and the service we've gotten from Albuquerque Indian that the touring the bike that we're upgrading this fat boy to is the Indian Roadmaster. So we're looking forward to that for next year. We'll do a couple of long tours, one of which will be Sturgis, and then we're hoping to go to Daytona Bike Week in 2023. So there's my Buell. This was my dream bike when they first came out. I test rode it at Daytona Bike Week, I believe in 2004. At the time, they only had the XB9s. So it was a smaller displacement engine that Buell had at the time. And then 2004, the year that I test rode that one, they came out with this XB12R with the 1203cc motor. This produces, I think, the same amount of torque or just a hair under what my Indian does. I believe it's either 84 or 87 foot-pounds of torque out of this engine and 103 or 105 horsepower at the crank. So when I'm talking horsepower with both of my bikes, this one at 103 or 105 and the Indian at 120, that's at the crank. I don't know what the rear wheel horsepower is, and it really doesn't matter to me. The bikes are outstanding. They got plenty of juice. Same thing with the Sporty. Anybody really wants to know what the rear wheel horsepower is, go dyno your bike if you're really into that. For me, the bikes perform outstanding just the way they are. But there's a lot of folks out there that want to talk specs and horsepower, torque numbers. Just like my buddy, his Sporty is just a few pounds lighter than my Indian. But if you're a fat ass and you're riding that Sportster and you're a more in shape person and you're riding the Indian, your bike's going to weigh a whole lot less with you on the Indian than a fat ass on the Sporty or vice versa. And when it comes down to single digits on horsepower and torque and pounds, it's negligible. And when I ride with my friend, whether we're both riding the Buells or I'm on my Sporty and he's on his V-Rod or whatever bike, or I'm on my Indian and he's on his Sporty, we ride to have fun. We don't ride to race each other. And if you folks out there, those of you that are into measuring dick size, well, have at it. For me, I just want to have fun riding my bikes. And sorry to get in a little bit of a soapbox there, but it kind of irritated me the other day. I haven't been on Facebook for a while, but my wife is, and I had become a member of an FTR group on Facebook when I was on it. And at the time, it seemed like a pretty good group. But when I posted some stuff on my friends, Sportster and my Indian, when we went out for a ride a couple of days ago, I just don't get guys that are into checking stats. And one guy actually saved the picture of my Indian and then blew it up close in to look at the rear tire tread wear near the sidewall, because they had a problem with me getting 46 miles to the gallon on my Indian. Hey man, if you want to ride your bikes at full throttle, will there be a Grom, a Harley-Davidson, an Indian, a Kawasaki, or whatever the hell you're riding, and if you want to ride at full throttle all the time, well, all the power to you, man. Me, I'll crank throttle when I want to, but I just want to have fun. I pay too much money for these bikes to wreck them, and I have wrecked. It's not a matter, if you ride, it's not a matter of if, it's when you're going to wreck and how bad it's going to be. And I've wrecked on my Sportster. And it was not at a high speed, but I still wrecked it, and it still cost me a chunk of change to fix it. And a little bit of road burn. But look, man, all the power to you if you want to be on that throttle at 3/4 or 100% the whole time. And I don't care what kind of bike you ride. If you're throttling that much, you ain't going to get shit for gas mileage. So anyway, enough of that. Today is all about the Buell. I rode the Indian this morning to the gym. My heated grips, which I got as an option. I'll talk more about my Indian at another video. Definitely worth the money, because this morning we were I think 42 degrees when I rode down to Santa Fe to hit the gym at about 6 o'clock this morning. So this bike here, looking forward to taking her out today, detail it a little bit more, get down there to Santa Fe Harley-Davidson, maybe throw my wife a hello in Santa Fe because she works there at one of the hospitals. And with that, I'll probably make a little bit more of a video. I might do a little bit of GoPro on this and put this together and have it out this evening or tomorrow. And with that, for now, Espinosa out. that does my writing part of the video. And here at Harley-Davidson, say hello to my two classmates, the one I ride with, Dennis the Menace. He lives right down the road from me, about 12 miles away. And my other classmate, Dustin Hughes, who manages the sales team here at Harley-Davidson. Classmates from the Mexico Military Institute, that is. So back here at Santa Fe Harley-Davidson, rode the Buell today. Always fun to ride this bike. I try not to put too many miles on it because parts are extremely hard to come by. Right now I get most of my parts from St. Paul Harley-Davidson. They're the only ones that seem to have stocked up or did some prep work when Harley-Davidson unceremoniously closed down Buell. Those of you familiar with Buell know that whole story. Harley-Davidson made a big mistake. Well, number one, they hired the wrong guy to be the CEO, who didn't even ride a motorcycle, never ridden a motorcycle, and shuts down Buell. Just as Buell was actually increasing sales, as Harley sales were going down, Buell was actually going up. So they stepped on their crank on that one. But good to see the motor company snapped out of their days there and is coming back. At least I hope they are. I don't follow the stock market or anything, but I know there's been talk of Harley-Davidson slipping, but hopefully the Sportster-S and the Pan America and whatever comes out in 2022, hopefully off that Revolution Max engine, means good news for the motor company. So there she is. This was my bucket list bike for many, many years. I couldn't afford them when they first came out. And kind of dropped into my lap with a California transplant who was scared of her bike. I love this bike. And Buell is back without Eric Buell. Eric Buell's off doing big things with electric motorcycles. I think Fuel is the name of the company that he's a partner of. But Buell is back with the guy who bought out EBR when they liquidated. And we all thought that was the end of Buell. And the EBR bikes based on Buell. Won't get into the details of why it was called EBR, but the bottom line is Harley-Davidson retained the naming rights of Buell when they got rid of Eric Buell's company. And now Buell is back with a guy that bought the liquidation assets from EBR. And they got a bike out right now called Hammerhead or something like that. But those familiar with Buell and EBR will recognize it as the 1190. Which is an awesome machine. It's just a raw sport bike. Now I'm looking forward to hopefully the company having success, and we have three American motor companies. But right now the big dogs, as it was in the very beginning, is Indian and Harley-Davidson. So walk in here after I put my dadgum, what I call the Roñosa mask, with this garbage with the Rona. I'll be back on maybe for a little bit if they got the Sportster-S in there. For now, Espinoza out. Well, hello, I'm back. Just got done saying hello to my pals over at Santa Fe Harley-Davidson. The new Sporty-S was not there, so nothing on the video this time for the Sportster-S. But a little bit of, not really drama, but it wouldn't be a ride if there wasn't some kind of little adventure. This piece here finally fell off and wasn't a piece that for me to think of with my Buell to check. I checked my tire pressure, my signals, all that other crap, but didn't think about checking that. So I lost that somewhere about 3 miles back. So when I looking to shift gears here at the light to turn left to go home, couldn't shift and looked down and my the clutch lever there was just kind of dangling down. And so luckily the Home Depot was right around the corner to the right. And these being, although most of the internals of this bike is specific to Buell, including the heads, it's still a Harley-Davidson based engine based off of the Sportster. So it's heavy on the torque. So I was able to clutch it in on, I was in second gear. So I was able to bring it in second gear riding the clutch a little bit, only for, I don't know, maybe a few hundred yards. So stopped in over here at Home Depot and spent $8 on a bunch of screws that I'm probably gonna need anyway. And I know the threads ain't exactly right on this with the threads on the clutch lever over here, but anyway, it works, and this will get me home until I'm able to put something better on. But I got about 30-mile ride home, and it ought to be able to stay. If not, I got plenty of screws to pull over to the side of the freeway. So I always carry a few tools, and I didn't bring all my tools, but enough to get this done. And my luckily, I decided to bring this because I wasn't going to bring that luggage rack. So a little bit of drama, not too bad on the Buell, and I'm operational again. And with that, from northern New Mexico on the 2004 Buell Firebolt, Espinoza out.